What if we wrapped the list back on itself, linking the last node to the first to create a loop? Now we have a circular linked list. While this would make a great symbol for the eternal cycle of life and death, it's also useful for representing repeating sequences, such as a rotating schedule. In this case, the head points to the node whose turn it is in the schedule. We can go through the cycle by advancing the head pointer forward to its next node. This can be thought of as rotating the entire sequence, like turning a dial. If we want to add something new to the schedule, we usually insert it in the position right before the head, so it will be processed after all of the elements currently in the cycle. This makes it so tail pointers are super useful in circular linked lists. We'll add new elements after the tail, then move the tail forward to point to the new node. And whenever we advance through the cycle, we move the tail forward just like the head. You might notice that the tail and head pointers are always immediately adjacent to each other, with the tail pointing to the head. So storing both pointers is a bit redundant. We can get rid of the head pointer since we can always access it through the next field of the tail node, and we still maintain the ability to super quickly add nodes to the end of the cycle by placing them after the tail node.